Geckos are fascinating members of the reptile family, belonging to the suborder Geckota. With a staggering count of over 1,600 species, these lizards have made their presence felt in warm climates around the world, except for the cold terrains of Antarctica. Most geckos are nocturnal, coming to life when the sun sets. Their large, captivating eyes are perfectly adapted for nighttime activities. An interesting behavior observed in geckos is their ability to shed their tails as a defense mechanism against predators. How big can geckos get? Geckos can come in a wide range of sizes. The tiniest among them is the dwarf gecko, which measures a mere 0.6 inches in length, making it not only the smallest gecko, but also the smallest lizard in existence. On the other end of the spectrum, the tokay gecko stands as the largest of its kind. Native to Southeast Asia, the tokay gecko can attain a length ranging from 10 to 14 inches. This species is easily recognizable due to its gray coloration adorned with red and blue spots. While these two species represent the extremes in gecko sizes, many other geckos fall somewhere in between. For instance, the banded gecko, a native North American species, can grow up to 6 inches in length. Are geckos good pets? Geckos have become a popular choice among reptile enthusiasts. While there are over 1,600 different species of geckos, not all are commonly kept as pets. When considering geckos as pets, it's essential to understand their care requirements. These creatures are relatively low maintenance, making them suitable for both novice and experienced reptile keepers. They need specific lighting, especially UVB, which aids in the synthesis of vitamin D3, crucial for their bone health. Temperature regulation is vital. Their enclosures should maintain a range of 75 to 85 degrees Fahrenheit during the day and 65 to 75 degrees Fahrenheit at night. Additionally, a basking spot with temperatures between 90 to 95 degrees Fahrenheit is recommended. Handling geckos requires gentleness, as they are generally non-aggressive but can become stressed if mishandled. While they are not known to be naturally aggressive, like all animals, they might bite if threatened or scared. What do geckos eat? Geckos, whether in the wild or in captivity, have a diet primarily composed of insects. In their natural habitats, these reptiles feast on a variety of insects such as moths, beetles, and flies. Their diet doesn't stop there. They also consume other small invertebrates, including spiders and millipedes. Their opportunistic feeding habits ensure they get a diverse range of nutrients essential for their growth and well-being. When kept as pets, geckos' dietary needs remain largely insectivorous. Crickets are a staple in their diet, often supplemented with mealworms and superworms for added variety. These insects are readily available at local pet stores and are generally affordable. Some gecko enthusiasts even raise crickets at home, although they can be noisy and have a distinct odor. Occasionally, geckos in captivity can be treated with waxworms, which are high in fat content and serve as a nutritious treat. Can geckos regenerate their tails? Geckos possess a remarkable ability that sets them apart from many other creatures. They can regenerate their tails. This capability is not just a simple growth. It's a complex process that has intrigued scientists for years. In the wild, when faced with a threat, geckos can voluntarily drop or detach their tails, a phenomenon known as autotomy. This serves as a defense mechanism, distracting predators and allowing the gecko to escape. The tail doesn't just fall off without reason, it's a strategic move. Once detached, the tail continues to twitch, drawing the predator's attention. But what's even more fascinating is the gecko's ability to regrow a new tail within just 30 days, faster than any other type of lizard. This rapid regeneration is a testament to the gecko's resilience and adaptability. How do geckos stick to walls and ceilings? Geckos have an extraordinary ability to stick to surfaces, allowing them to effortlessly climb walls and even hang upside down on ceilings. But how do they achieve this? The secret lies in the intricate design of their feet. Geckos possess thousands of tiny hair-like structures called setae on the soles of their feet. Each seta further branches out into even smaller structures known as spatulae, increasing the surface area of contact. These setae and spatulae exploit a phenomenon known as the van der Waals force. This force results from the temporary molecular attractions that occur when atoms come in close proximity to each other. Due to the vast number of spatulae on a gecko's foot, these forces collectively provide a strong adhesive effect, allowing geckos to stick to surfaces. Interestingly, not all gecko species have this sticky ability. For instance, while the house gecko and tokay gecko can effortlessly climb walls, the leopard gecko lacks this capability. How do geckos clean their eyes? Geckos have a unique and intriguing way of keeping their eyes clean. Unlike many animals, geckos lack eyelids. This means they can't blink or close their eyes to protect them from dust and debris. So how do they manage to keep their eyes clean and moist? The answer lies in their tongue. Geckos use their long, agile tongues to lick their eyes. This action not only removes dirt and debris, but also helps to moisten the eye. Their saliva plays a dual role in this process. It aids in cleaning the eye and provides relief, especially during drier conditions, ensuring their vision remains unobstructed and clear. How many species of geckos are there? There are over 1,600 different species of geckos, each with its unique characteristics and habitats. Let's delve into a few notable species. The leopard gecko, native to the deserts of Asia and India, is renowned for its distinctive spotted appearance. It's a favorite among reptile enthusiasts due to its docile nature and relatively simple care requirements. Then there's the crested gecko, originating from New Caledonia. This species is recognized for its unique crests and its remarkable ability to climb glass walls, a feature that often astonishes pet owners. The tokay gecko, native to Southeast Asia, is known for its vibrant coloration, often a mix of blue and orange-red spots. It's larger than many other gecko species and has a distinctive call that sounds like tokay. What is the average lifespan of a gecko? In the wild, geckos face numerous challenges, from predators to environmental factors, which can impact their longevity. On average, wild geckos can live up to 15 years, given they successfully navigate these challenges. In contrast, when in captivity, geckos often experience a longer lifespan. The controlled environment, regular feeding, and absence of natural predators contribute to their extended life. Captive geckos can live anywhere from 10 to 20 years, with some species even reaching the higher end of this range. For instance, the leopard gecko, a popular pet choice, has a different lifespan in the wild compared to captivity. In its natural habitat, a leopard gecko reaching 8 years is considered to have lived a long life. However, in captivity, without the pressures and dangers of the wild, they can live more than 20 years. What kind of sound does a gecko make? Geckos are among the few lizards known for their vocalizations. Contrary to the silent nature of many reptiles, geckos often communicate using a variety of sounds. The most commonly heard sounds from geckos include chirps, clicks, and barks. These vocalizations are not just random noises. They have specific meanings and purposes. For instance, the leopard gecko uses its noises to attract mates, signal defensiveness, and warn other geckos of their territory. The name gecko itself is derived from an Indonesian word that mimics the sound made by a specific gecko species native to Indonesia. However, it's worth noting that not all gecko species produce this particular sound. In New Zealand, local gecko species have their unique set of vocalizations, distinct from the gecko sound of their Indonesian counterpart. Geckos utilize these sounds for various reasons, such as attracting mates, establishing territory, warning of potential threats, and communicating with fellow geckos. As we delve deeper into the world of geckos, it becomes evident that their vocalizations play a crucial role in their behavior and interactions. Thank you for tuning in to learn more about geckos. But don't forget, there's plenty more to discover on our channel. If you found the information valuable, please consider liking the video and subscribing to our channel. Don't forget to hit the notification bell so you won't miss our upcoming content. We're interested in hearing your thoughts or any questions you might have about geckos, so please leave a comment below.